Good morning. Listen to a paraphrase of someone on which we base today's call to worship. The truly happy person does not follow wicked advice, does not stand on the road of sinners, and does not sit with the disrespectful. Instead, the truly happy loves the Lord's instruction and recites God's instruction day and night. The blessed person is like a tree replanted by streams of water, which bears fruit at just the right time, and whose leaves don't fade. Whatever he does succeeds. This is not true for the wicked, who are like dust that the wind blows away. The Lord is intimately acquainted with the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked is destroyed. We devote this time to honor and worship Almighty God, God of the righteous, the blessed, the happy, the God of love. Praise be to God. Come, let us worship the Lord. Receive our praise and thanksgiving today. Though we are a sinful people, yet you love us. We are a rebellious people, yet you forgive us. And though by our words and actions we create a distance from your holy presence and will, yet in Christ you heal the breach and bring us close to you once more. We praise you. By your Spirit, help us today to remember the power of your love and resurrection, and recreate us to be the people of hope, faith, joy, and love. All praise be unto you, O God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning. We all face challenges, struggles, despairs, failures, trials, temptations, difficulties, uncertainties, and times when things don't go the way we hope for. Months before Christmas in the year 2019, na-diagnose ako na may anxiety. I asked myself, why? I searched for answers and I realized that one of the reasons was I tend to overthink and without consulting God in everything. That I base my decisions on my own conviction. The process of healing was one of the most terrifying things that I endured. There was even a time that I didn't see myself overcoming this health setback. I struggled with deep disappointment with God, and the process of recovery was a journey of total surrender to Him hanggang ayon. What happened to me is a demonstration of His goodness and steadfast love. God spared me from worse complications. Psalm 46 is a strong biblical passage which reminded me that even in the face of trouble, God is our refuge and strength. It is in the tough times of life that we find out what we are really made of. The Bible says trials and difficulties must come to test our character and to test our faith. To strengthen our faith, you must have adversities to conquer and attacks to withstand. Moreover, it's in the tough times of life that we find out what we're really made of. With a grateful heart and a resilient faith, I declare that anxiety has no place in the life of a believer. Once a pastor said, "For the child of God, good is permanent and bad is only temporary. God is faithful. He uses our trials for our good and His glory to draw closer to Him and give us a testimony of His faithfulness. He always has a plan. For every painful experience, He gives ample grace. He heals and restores." I rest in the words of 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10, which says, "And the God of all grace, who called you to His eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will Himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast." God is a miracle-working God. He knows what I am going through, and He will not let me down. God is mightier than my problem and anxiety. In James chapter 1, verses 2 to 3 says, "Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. If I work with God and keep a good attitude, then no matter what comes against me, the Bible says, that all things, yes, not just the good things in life, but all things will work together for my good. I am much in a better place now than I was 2 years ago. I praise God for His faithfulness. To God be the glory."
We love because God loved us first. As the secular world celebrates Valentine's Day tomorrow, we remember to celebrate it in the love of Christ.
Not much is factually known of the original patron saint of Valentine's Day, Saint Valentine's. It is said that Valentinus was a priest and physician in ancient Rome, well known for his kindness and generosity towards others, caring for the poor, performing good deeds, and healing the sick and afflicted. He was arrested by the Roman Emperor Claudius Gothicus during the time of Christian persecution. It was said that during his time under arrest, he healed his attending officer's blind adopted daughter, which led to the officer's family's conversion to Christianity. Gothicus heard of these deeds and ordered Saint Valentine's to be beheaded on February 14. In 496 AD, Pope Gelasius officially added February 14 as a holiday on the Roman Catholic Church's list as Saint Valentine's Day. The emphasis was not meant to reflect romantic love, but to honor Saint Valentine and his life of service and goodwill. Over the centuries, the day had been applied to courtly and romantic love, celebrated with the exchange of tokens and romantic declarations. In 1969, the Roman Catholic Church removed Saint Valentine's Day from the general Roman Catholic calendar. Valentine's Day had become a purely secular holiday, although Saint Valentinus is still recognized as a saint included in the Roman Catholic martyrology. So let us mark what has become a secular and heavily commercialized day by remembering God's unconditional love and his command for us to love others unconditionally through words and actions. Let us not love in word or talk, but in deed and in truth. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Happy Valentine's Day.
Magkaisa. natin sila. Magturuan tayo, sundin natin ang ating Panginoon. Magmahalan, magmahalan tayo, ano pa man ang ating kinalalagyan.
Good morning. Today's Old Testament reading is found in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verses 5 to 10. Thus says the Lord, cursed are those who trust in mere mortals and make mere flesh their strength, whose heart turns away from the Lord. They shall be like a shrub in the desert and shall not see when relief comes. They shall live in the parched places of the wilderness, in uninhabited salt lands. Blessed are those who trust in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. They shall be like tree planted by waters, sending out its roots by the stream. It shall not fear when heat comes, and its leaves shall stay green in the year of drought. It is not anxious, and it does not cease to bear fruit. The heart is devious above all else. It is perverse. Who can understand it? I, the Lord, test the mind and search the heart to give all according to their ways, according to the fruit of their doings. This is the word of the Lord.
The reading from the epistles is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 12 to 20. Now if Christ is proclaimed as raised from the dead, how can some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? If there is no resurrection of the dead, then Christ has not been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, then our proclamation has been in vain, and your faith has been in vain. We are even found to be misrepresenting God, because we have testified of God that he raised Christ, whom he did not raise, if it is true that the dead are not raised. For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised. If Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile, and you are still in your sins. Then those also who have died in Christ have perished. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. The word of the Lord.
The Gospel lesson, Luke chapter 6, verses 17 to 26. He came down with them and stood on a level place with a great crowd of his disciples and a great multitude of people from all Judea, Jerusalem, and the coast of Tyre and Sidon. They had came to hear him and to be healed of their diseases, and those who were troubled with unclean spirits were cured. And all in the crowd were trying to touch him, for power came out from him and healed all of them. Then he looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you and when they exclude you, repel you and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven, for that is what their ancestor did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is what their ancestor did to the false prophets." This is the word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Oh, come on.
Good morning, and today we will going again to reflect on the Word of God, and today also is part of our celebration is for us to remember the love of God, and of course, the love that we need to emulate as we live our lives in accordance to God's will. Our message is entitled, The First Fruits. Jesus is the model of living and loving and dying and rising. And while we may not really know what happens at the threshold moment between this life and eternity, we embrace the promise and the hope wholeheartedly. Quoting from umcdiscipleship.org. We will reflect on our life and our life of trust. There is constant struggle between principles we believe as well as models we follow in our lives on earth. How then we respond on opposing views? Shall we put our trust on mere mortal suppositions? Or shall we continue to adhere with our faith in the Lord? Let us pray. As we reflect, Lord God, on your word, we pray that your Spirit will lead us, Lord God, and make this day a day for us to realize how important to put our trust in you. O Holy Spirit, give us wisdom. Open our mind and our hearts. And may your name be glorified in our midst. In Jesus' mighty name, this is our prayers. Amen. Christians today, supposedly privileged of having constant guide in conducting our lives. We have the lives of people who serve as our role model. We have the Bible for us to live. As Christians, we must know how to conduct our lives and know to whom we put our trust. Our trust and confidence will lead us into a definite direction towards our ultimate aspirations as people of God. As for one, the incarnation of Jesus Christ defined the guidepost towards our ultimate destinations as followers of God. Jesus is the first fruit, and he is our model. There are four things that our lectionary or our worship guide is giving us hint on how to look at Jesus and emulate Jesus in our lives. First, Jesus as our model of living. We know as Christians that coming from the word Christian, there comes the word Christ. Christ, I am nothing. With Christ, we can differentiate how to live our lives according to Christ's will or otherwise. With Christ, we will know whether we are doing fine or not, because Christ provided the norm and standard of living. The bodily Jesus established our Christian norms in the way we live our lives. The bumper sticker WWJD, What Would Jesus Do, connotes our adherence to the teaching of Jesus or in conducting ourselves in certain situations. We ask, what would Jesus do in such situation? This world taught us that those norms and standards are relative in different societies. But we know as Christians, we must adhere to the teaching of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are part of the body of Christ who believe in Jesus as our role model in our day-to-day living. We Christians has a definite way of grasping things. In everything, we use the lens of Jesus to understand and to respond. Jesus as our role model in living. Secondly, Jesus, our model of loving. Kung magtatanong ka ng isang tao na inimbody niya yung totoong kahulugan ng pag-ibig, you can see Jesus atop of all those people who embodied love. Jesus as the role model in our ways of loving people is really atop the highest standards of Christian living, and it is expressed in love. Christian ethics is based on Jesus' principle of living and loving, and Christ's ethos is love translated on concrete ways towards people. Christ's love never hindered by the differences of the people around him, not even the negative attitudes of people around him. Jesus even tells us, I give you a new commandment. Love one another. Just as I have loved you, you must also love one another. From John chapter 13. Jesus continually inviting us to express that love in concrete ways, even in the midst of differences. Love must prevail. Love is the way so that we will be someone who can live in this life without being judgmental, without being not that kind of person who discriminate people, but you will become a person, a people who embrace differences and invite to come together by the grace of God. Let's put love into action. And that's the kind of Jesus love for everybody. We celebrate love, but of course, we also practice love. We are not just in the realm of an abstract love, but we continue to make love and show love in concrete ways. Ngayong araw ng mga puso, let those love will not just came out of our mouth, but let those love will also be seen through our hands, through our actions. And that love should be exemplify the love of God who is able to embrace the world. Jesus became our role model of how to love. Thirdly, Jesus, our model of dying. Alam nyo, sa buhay natin, lalo na sa panahon ngayon, there are so many things that we need to sacrifice in order for us to follow the will of God. Sometimes, kailangan mong lunukin ang iyong pride, kailangan mong harapin yung bigat ng buhay just to follow the direction of the Lord. Even Jesus faced such kind of situation during his time, that even in the face of death, Jesus Christ put his trust in the Lord, that though he is overwhelmed with fear, overwhelmed with all of those negative thoughts, but, you know, Jesus faced them squarely. And Jesus put his trust in the hands of God. In Mark chapter 14, verses 34, Jesus said, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch." Sabi niya doon sa kanyang mga alagad. To the following verse, in verse 36, sa kanyang pananalangin, paikipag-usap sa Ama, "Abba, Father," he said, "everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will." Even in the face of danger, in the face of death, Jesus Christ can surrender everything to God. Kahit merong sakit, kahit merong mga bagay na maaaring magpadalawang isip sa Kanya, but Jesus Christ, with full trust in the Lord, surrendered everything and embraced death, because we know the kind of trust, the kind of confidence Jesus has for God is that long, how wide or grabe yung kahulugan nito para sa Kanya. Jesus, even in the time of dying, in the time of sacrifices, Jesus can be our role model. And lastly, Jesus as our model of rising. And that's actually part of the fruit of his trust to God, that despite of those dangers, death, and sacrifices, he put himself on the hands of God, he surrendered everything, and the result is that God giving him victory. That he was risen from the dead. Out of God's Jesus' trust in God, Jesus became victorious. Sa gitna ng mga panganib sa ating buhay, we can entrust ourselves to God. Na sa gitna ng mga problema, tayo'y patuloy na umaangat at nagtatagumpay, sapagkat ang ating pinagtitiwala ang Diyos ay nangako ng katagumpayan sa sino mang magtitiwala sa Kanya. And one time, during his lifetime, Jesus said in John 11:25, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die." Do you believe this? Jesus is telling us that even in death, there is victory. for those who believe in Him. Just like our Lord Jesus Christ, who surrendered everything, He became victorious. And so, at this time of many people being hopeless of our situations, at this time when many people were dying, we can still be victorious if we will put our trust just like Jesus put His trust to the Father. Jesus is our model in even in our rising. Jesus as a model of living and loving, dying and rising, is deeply rooted on His trust to God. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, the Son can do nothing by Himself. He can do only what He sees His Father doing, because whatever the Father does, the Son also does." Jesus' life is our model. He is the first, and we follow His ways. Our eyes are fixed on Jesus, and we emulate His ways. As I end this message this morning, in Jeremiah chapter 17, and even in Psalms chapter 1, it says that blessed are those who trust in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. Happy are those who do not follow the advice of the wicked or take the path of the sinner's tread, but their delight is in the law of the Lord, and on His law they meditate day and night. They are like the trees planted by the streams of the water, and in all they do, they prosper. Even in Jeremiah and in Psalms, those scriptures were telling us to put our trust in God, whatever situations we have in life, in our day-to-day living, in our way on how to show our love and compassion to people, in the face of death or sacrifices in life, and even after death, we must put our trust in God. Let us be people of faith whose eyes is fixed in the Lord Jesus Christ. And in that way, we will be assured of victory in the name of our Lord Jesus. Brothers and sisters, every one of you, wherever you are, let us remember that Jesus was the first fruit. And He Himself was the seed planted in His dying and grew in His resurrection. We look at Jesus. Jesus as our model. We emulate Him, His way of living and loving. And we hope in His dying and rising. We are the fruit of the first fruit. That by the life of Jesus Christ, the way how He lived His life, had invited us and made us the fruit of whatever Jesus did, and we too can be a seed to be planted in the life of many people as we invite them to to also trust in God in whatever situations we have in life. May God embrace us and put hope in our hearts. And may God continue to express His love in your life, in your day-to-day living, and make you victorious, now and forever. Amen.
The Lord abides with us and grants us blessedness in our lives. Thanksgiving is an act of worship by way of offering back to God a portion what we have earned from the work of our ordinary everyday lives. Let us now offer our gifts, tithes, and offerings to the service of the Lord.
We lift our voices, we lift our hands, we lift our lives up to you, we are an offering. Lord, use our hands. Lord, use our lives. We are yours. We are an offering. All that we have, all that we are, all that we hope to be, we give to you. We give
Let's pray. Sovereign God, we give our tithes and gifts this day, affirming that you deserve the best we have to offer. We are reminded that we are called to give our first fruits, the first and the best that we have, and not what is left over. Just as the Apostle Paul reminds us that our Lord Jesus Christ was the first fruit in your new covenant of salvation for each of us, may we live lives and give gifts worthy of your first fruit. Thank you for all you give us. We give back to you in love and gratitude. In Christ's name, Amen.
Yeah.
Let us pray. O Lord, we come to you to praise and to acknowledge you as our model. We want, Lord God, to know you more and put in our hearts the ability to trust you. Help us to grasp your will and your directions for our lives, that in our way of living, loving, and even in dying and rising, we can acknowledge your ever-present help, even in times of need, and of course, those things that you give us, that in every day of our lives, we know that you are with us and giving us what we need. We pray, Lord God, that each one of us will truly follow your ways. That above all, Lord God, we must adhere to your way of doing our lives in a way that is acceptable and life that will give glory to God in the heaven. We pray also, Lord God, that as we remember the day when we put stress on love, let this not just by words, but helps us, Lord God, to emulate and articulate the way on how you show love to people around you. May the God who called us to be part of the body, will also give us concrete ways on how to express your love through our way of living, of loving, of dying and rising. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We have proclaimed the presence and power of the risen Christ with the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts. We have been taught true happiness and blessedness. Now, as we go forth to our daily lives at home, work, study, play, and ministry, let us demonstrate the presence and the power of the risen Christ with the deeds of our hands and the labor of our lives. And the blessings and powerful mercies of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, always be with you. Amen. Good morning to all of you. God bless you all. We thank you for coming and joining us in our worship and of course via Vidcast. And may God continue to give you hope and all of those prayers be answered by our God. May the Lord continuously bless each one of us with good health and strength. We invite everybody in our ministries online, and it is ongoing. Just feel free to join us in our Sunday school immediately after our service and to our Bible studies within the week and also during our midweek service. Reach out to your workers or through our Facebook account page through private message, and we will going to refer you in our ministries. We continue to encourage our KFUMC friends and families to continue giving your tithes and offering. This is our commitment to the Lord as an act of praise and thanksgiving to help and support the ministries of the church. You may give to the means that is most convenient to you through direct deposit to our PNB account or e-giving via PayPal or PayMaya. Also, via drop-off to the church. Just please do inform us about your giving, and we are very much happy to guide you or to assist you in your giving. May God continue to bless all of you. We also want to express our thanksgiving to those who participated, who serve as our worship servants today. We thank Mirna Refuerzo for being our leader this morning, and to our readers, Dr. Dennis Almonte, Sister Paz DiPano, and of course to our editor, Sister Grace Atela, and for the music ministry of KFUMC, for the choir, and of course for our editors, kapatid na Arnel DiPano. And we thank also Dr. Raul Supnet for making ready of our hymns so that we can sing together as congregation. We thank you all for helping the church to be someone who can be of help to make our worship service more vibrant and meaningful to everybody. A blessed birthday to the following celebrators this week from February 13 to February 19. Happy birthday to the following, and your names will be flashed on your screens. And for today, February 13, happy birthday to Ariel Victoria Aurora DiPano Calub, kay Naomi Ruth Cabral, Merly Palaganas Binoa, Nelly Palaganas, Hilariel Pascual,
Mercury Palaganas, Liza Toledo, Pat Orvano, Norma Bernardes, Trina Sorina Abisamis, and Wilfredo Martin. May God continue to give you life and more years, and all of them be pleasing to our God. Praise God for all of your life. Praise God for this morning. To God be all the glory. Amen.